So first we see the actual apps, how it work to store a database, store a data, specific data of registration form to store in MySQL server or MySQL database. Okay, now see, this is the main page. It's shown where the field or some definite field are there. There is name, I click on that, and May, this is Shubhayu. Then mobile number, I put it. Now date of birth, they are the given format is there, DDMMYI. So give, suppose, then class, it may be class 10, class 11, class 12. I put class 12. Now the option is school name. See, I suppose I give the name Balurghat High School. Then the field is email ID. I field suppose my email ID. Now user ID, may I give user ID Shubhayu. Now the password, may password I give simple password 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Now after completing the all data field, I press register button and see, wait for the response. Is it completed? Yeah, records added successfully, it shows. How it is possible? How we build this app? Exactly, how we build this app? So this app is built in MIT App Inventor. Okay, see this page we design. There is a 8 field, we use the 8 level here. Yeah, those are the level: name, mobile number, date of birth, class, school, email, user ID and password. And then we use different text fields, 7 text fields for taking the name, mobile number, date of birth, class, school, email, user ID, and one special password text class, text field to take a password. Okay, see here the password text box for getting a password, and one button we use for register purpose. When you click this register, we see already in example, when you press this register button, the data is registered. And after this designing, we come to here the block section, that means the logic functions. Okay, now we know this project can be possible only the combination of MySQL server and PHP and the MIT App Inventor. So in our PHP, we write a program, we show later what the program we write, And for that, to operate in PHP, we have to send a proper URL where our PHP file is stored. With this URL, we can send the data from App Inventor to PHP. Okay, so for that, see how I build that. We take an initial one variable by initializing it 0. Blank. We take another variable named temp URL. We take another variable named rate. Okay, now we have to make a proper URL. For that, see here I use when register click button. That means the button we use, register button, when it click, what will happen? Set global temp URL that variable will be set it by joining the URL http://siemapps.net16.name/siem.php. This SIEM PHP I build, I show you later in this PHP what I retain inside that. And now check, we create this URL to sending the PHP values. Now we write in question mark after first name is equal to what the value customer field in text box, it will be added. Now it join with ampersand mobile number. That means after the name, we already see there is a mobile number here. See, after name there is a mobile number. So we have to send this mobile number followed by the name to join ampersand. In between this name and mobile number, there should be an ampersand to send via URL. That is why we used joining ampersand mobile number, and this mobile number take by the text field which feeded by a customer or user, you may say, then the date of birth. And same process continue, then class, then school name, then email, then user ID, and finally the password. So in that way we have to make this URL and send it, and we set it in global temp URL, and now we have to send it like that way. This set web1.url to set global temp the URL. That means the whatever the value we store in global temp URL, now it is set to the global the URL. Now this is sent by the web1. That means the following address, the following URL, whatever we give here, this is send it by taking those value which is customer feeded. Now another portion of this program is when the data is sent via URL. Now after some work, the server will respond the work has to be done or not. If the data is stored successfully, it will show the message record added successfully, or whatever the message send, it will shown us by the show notifier which we use in designer portion, and it will show the notification if the record is added or not. The earlier when we simulate this apps, we show after pressing the register button the message is come record added successfully. Now we see the we already store a data, we create a table nbcafe. See, the same variable is there, same field is there, and same sequence, first name, mobile number, date of birth, class, school name, email, user ID and password. Okay, we create this table inside a database in PHP MyAdmin and naming nbcafe. And see, when we simulate this program, now check this data was come or not. So those data are already coming here and storing the data over here. Okay, so when we press the submit button, the data is coming automatically. Now the main portion of that, the bridging between these apps and these MySQL servers server is the PHP, the code of PHP. See here, I write this code of PHP here. Now first we define the database user. What is your username? You have to mention here and define your password, database password, database host, and everything we have to write over here. And the last thing, you have to mention here. See, we create some variable like the first name and call this first name to get first name, which we put the value on the apps. This value is stored in this first name, and that this last name is same what like that. Father's name, mobile, date of birth, class, school, everything, whatever put in apps, it should be stored inside those red one. Okay, now we write a query, MySQL query, insert into nbcafe. Nbcafe is our table name. What should it insert? The first name. See, this first name is in database format. The table, in table we write the first name underscore name, first underscore name. See here, in database, see, first underscore name, mobile underscore name, number, date underscore of underscore birth. So in PHP we write the first one, the field name of our table in database. See, all the field we mention, and now in command the values, we have to put this field with values. Which value? The value come from which is stored in this first name, mobile, DOB, class, school, and password. And this store value is getting by this way to taking the app. So this is the main logic. Whatever value we put in apps, it will store in the variable here, and the value of this variable is stored in the MySQL database. And we give a if command. If the query is successful with database connection, then this record will add it successfully, and else it could give us the message error could not be able to execute. So in that way we simply make our project to store a certain value in MySQL database successfully. Thank you.